We all want to defend Islam for what we know, but at the same time, a lot more needs to be done across the community to represent the diversity and the beauty of our community. And you know, allow me just one point on diversity. I strongly believe that the Muslim community can hold the key to solutions to diversity because of the nature of our faith. Diversity in Islam is a matter of faith. We live it, we love it, and we should believe in it and practice it. Diversity in the history of this nation, at one point, it became point of conflict, point of struggle, point of discrimination and killing. People are being murdered just because of their skin color in this country, in the past and even now. The Muslim community has answers to these solutions because as Muslims, we see each other equal in front of God. And we have to behave that way at all levels in our organizations and our communities. Wallah.
Inshallah. Before Zahra speaks, I want to mention that that question ties very much to a session that will be happening next. So at 3:40, there is a session called ISNA and You. It's the General Assembly meeting. And that is an opportunity to hear directly from Hazan Bata and Azhar Aziz and Altaf Hussein and others about the direction that ISNA is going and about its desire to undergo a very deep institutional strategic planning review and addressing some of the challenges that we are all sensing. Zahra.
So, quick three things. For those that don't know, outside of my work at CARE, one of the things that I have done is curated what we call the Muslim Women Speakers List. So for over 15 years now, I've been advocating for the inclusion of more and more women on these panels. I say this today as a main session speaker in my early 30s and as a woman, that it's important to also recognize progress. ISNA has made significant progress in the diversity of its speakers. I think at last count, 48% of the total program speakers are women. That was unimaginable when I first started to notice that we had too many all-male panels in our community. Not even too many, it was the entire thing. So we are making progress as a community. One of the things I said is we have to continue to patiently persevere. Change takes time. And those that knew me 5 years into my activism can tell you how frustrated I was. 10 years into my activism, I was so frustrated. In year 12, I curated the list. And even still today, sometimes I'll hear about an event that is all male speakers. It takes time, but places like ISNA are a good way to make progress. The second thing, inshallah, the second thing is to always be conscious of the privilege that exists among those of us that can attend these conferences. Brother Nihad said this, attending a conference like this could easily run you $1,000 for the whole weekend. Airfare alone is $300 to $400, hotels are $300 to $400, and convention food, $20, $30, $50 a day. When so many Muslim families live at or below the poverty line in our country, it's not necessarily the organization's fault that we don't have more diversity. And by diversity, it can't also be racial diversity. It's socioeconomic diversity, it's gender diversity, it's ethnic diversity. And I appreciate that ISNA has continued to review its model to see how can costs be cut down? How do we bring conferences to communities in Ohio, in California, and other places? So people who can't afford a Labor Day weekend ticket to Chicago can still have access. And then the last thing is this thing that Mazen said about the session. As someone who runs a small nonprofit organization and sits with others who do this, we welcome volunteers. We can never get enough help. And so please go to the ISNA and You session, reach out to the program committee, volunteer with them to think about how we raise money for sponsorship so that people who can't afford to come can be sponsored to come. So that communities that maybe don't receive all of the marketing can get the marketing materials. And the countless other ways that this organization, which is doing really important work, can continue to grow and improve. It's on all of us.
Thank you. Abdurrahman, I see a group of people looking to maybe ask questions. We only technically have 3 minutes left. I want to have each of the questionnaires perhaps ask their questions in order, and then we'll have the speakers address them collectively as a way to wrap up the program. I ask, Abdurrahman has the authority to hold on to the mic, so please do not be offended. Please make your questions quick. If you have a comment, please make it brief so that we can get everyone who's standing looking to make a comment into the...
Okay, my name is Maurice Al-Khan. I am the Director of Operations of the Afia Foundation. We used to be known as the Peaceful Justice Foundation. My question is for Nihad. The former U.S. Attorney General Ramsey Clark has described the case of Dr. Afia Siddiqui as the worst case of individual injustice he has ever seen. And in my 25 years of doing human rights work in America, more than 25 years, it's the worst that I've seen. This case is symbolic of so many other cases. My question, as an African-American, middle-aged, well-known and respected human rights advocate, who often feels himself marginalized by my fellow organizations and leaders because of the issues we address, why have the major Muslim organizations consistently avoided this issue of Dr. Afia Siddiqui? She's now in her 13th year of imprisonment. I hope this question doesn't get lost in the sauce because it's a very, very important question.
Thank you for asking a very specific question. I'm sure they'll get addressed.
My name is Babar Khan. I'm from Minnesota, and I just want to start with one thing, at least to the moderator, is that Keith Ellison is not here. Do we feel obligated to at least tell the people that we are sorry Keith will not be here? Because something is in your brochure that Keith will be one of the speakers. My question is, we are talking about the opportunities ahead, and I heard, I know the portfolio of all these respected guests, and I really admire them. But we did not talk about the opportunities coming up. For example, like elections coming up. What will be our role in these elections? And how are we going to go back to the imams of the mosques, who many of those imams are like, they think democracy is anti-Islamic. We need to address that issue in the coming years, maybe.
Thank you.
And the onus was not on Islam. The onus that my question was really guided towards all the organizations, including particularly ICNA.
Thank you. I'm going to ask Nihad to talk about Dr. Afia's situation. I'll ask Zahra to tackle the issue of this upcoming elections. And I'll ask, since it was somewhat specific to ICNA, I'll ask Naeem to handle the issue of diversity within ICNA's approach to Islamic work as well. And then we'll wrap it up with some final thoughts, inshallah. Thank you.
Thank you. As far as the case of the Afia Siddiqui letter, of course, I'm not a lawyer, but my organization did a legal review. We had a private meeting with Brother Maurice Al-Khan, and I had the opportunity to have a meet with our legal team. Our legal team determined that the case has advanced so much that many filings were missed, and of course, CARE is a civil rights organization, so we deal with discrimination cases. We do not take criminal cases. Our community and people have to understand the difference between criminal cases and civil rights cases. There are other institutions within our community that deal with criminal justice issues, and we can work with them. The case is very, very complicated. It is beyond our legal capacity and our legal team. So we cannot just take a case because there is a pressure from someone who's organizing for them. Our community and activists have to see how they can direct their efforts in a wise manner so that we don't waste our resources just, you know, going and appealing to an organization that's outside its expertise. In other words, in simple terms, you do not go to an eye doctor for a heart issue. You go to an eye doctor if you have an eye issue. Similarly, with legal issues, you have to go to the specialist and those who have the capacity. A criminal case like this, Canada has not taken ever. We only take civil rights cases. And I have this conversation with my dear brother, but he always insists on pushing it beyond what we can.
Thank you. We'll go to Zaha.